Welcome to part 2 in the series of Fundamentals of Programming in CR Basic. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add data tables to a program and how to specify what outputs to store in a data table. I will start with the program I ended with in part 1. In this program, I have some variables declared, along with begin program and end program statements, and scan, next scan. I'm going to save this as a different program because I will be making significant changes to it. I'll call this one data tables. Now, I am free to make changes and save them without losing my previous work. Just about every CR Basic program is going to be used to store data. There is a whole section of CR Basic instructions devoted to data tables. Data tables are done in blocks that start with the data table instruction and end with the end table instruction. For the data table, there are three parameters. There is a name for the table, a trigger variable, and a size. The name is how the data table is labeled. I'm going to start with a 5-minute table, so I will call this first table 5min. Trigvar is used for tables that are called conditionally, or in other words, output is only saved if a certain condition is true. I will leave trigvar at true because I want my output saved on a time interval, not on a condition. Size specifies how much memory or the number of records to allocate for the data table in final storage memory. The default is -1, or auto-allocate, which tells the data logger to use all of the available memory. If there are multiple auto-allocated tables, the available memory is divided equally between the tables. I'm going to leave the size as -1, because I want to use all available memory. Because this is a time-driven table, I need to insert a data interval instruction to tell the data logger how often to store data. For data interval, there is a time into interval parameter, the time interval, and units. I will enter 5 for interval and minutes for units. The lapses parameter is usually left at its default value. Now that I have a data table, I need to define what data to save. If I try to save the table right now, I will get a compile error because I have not specified any outputs. I'm going to start by adding the average instruction to store an average of my decimal value. In the last video, I showed different variable types, but there are also different data types for final storage values. The two main data types shown in CR Basic are FP2 and IEEE4. FP2 takes up 2 bytes of memory, and IEEE4 takes up 4 bytes. Many values, such as air temperature, are fine to save as FP2 because the sensor accuracy is less than 4 significant digits. FP2 takes up half as much space, which means I can store twice as much data and it will download twice as fast. Whereas IEEE4 has an advantage of increased resolution and precision. So use IEEE4 if more than 4 significant digits are needed, but be aware that IEEE4 uses twice as much storage memory as FP2. For this example, I'm going to choose IEEE4. For now, I'm not going to change disable var or repetitions. Now, I can compile the program, but I have warnings. If I scroll down, I see that my table named 5min is declared but never called. For every data table, there has to be a corresponding call table instruction. So I will enter a call table instruction and right-click on the table name and choose the 5min table. Now I will add another table to my program. I will call this table Nightly Minimum. Next, I will add data interval to the table, and I will make this a 24-hour table. In this table, I want to store the minimum overnight temperature. The tricky part is that by default, a 24-hour interval begins at midnight and ends at midnight. But I want to store the minimum temperature that occurs between noon of one day and noon of the next day. So how do I change the interval from midnight to noon to noon? I can enter a value of 12 in the time into interval parameter, and that will shift the interval by 12 hours. Next, I will enter the minimum instruction. For source, I will choose other decimal, and for data type, I will choose IEEE 4. The minimum instruction also has an option to store the time that the minimum occurred. If the time parameter is true, the minimum instruction will output both the minimum and the time the minimum occurred. Now I can compile, but again I see a warning that I declared a table, but the table is not called. So I will go back and add another call table instruction. Usually, call table is placed after all measurements are made and before next scan. In other words, saving data is usually the last thing done in a scan. Now I will send the program and look at the Monitor Data tab. In addition to the public and status tables, I see my 5 min and nightly minimum tables. I don't have any records in these tables because neither of the intervals specified in the data interval instructions have passed yet. For the 5 min table, a new record will be stored at the top of each 5-minute interval. For the nightly minimum table, a new record will not be stored until noon tomorrow. While I'm waiting for my 5-minute interval to pass, I will look at the data table info table. This table shows what setting the table size to -1, or auto-allocate, did. In this case, I'm using a CR1000X, which has a lot of storage space. Data field days 1-1, which is the 5-minute table, can hold 64,564 days worth of data. Data field days 1-2 is used for cardout tables. Since my program does not use the cardout instruction, this value remains 0. Data field days 2-1, which is the nightly minimum table, can also hold 64,564 days worth of data. The number of days is the same because both tables are auto-allocated, which means the data logger allocated memory equally between the two tables based on time. Now when I look at the 5-min table, I see a record has been recorded at the top of a 5-minute interval, which tells me the program is working as expected. In summary, data tables start with the data table instruction and end with the end table instruction, and most of the time require a data interval instruction to specify how often to store data to a table. There is a list of data table instructions in CR Basic. Looking at the list of instructions in the data tables category, there is an average instruction to average data over a time period, and a sample instruction which saves only the last output value. So if I put a sample instruction in my 5-minute table, it will save the last value that occurred in that interval, rather than the average of all values that occurred in that interval. There is also a wind vector instruction that is useful when using any kind of wind sensor. There are instructions to store the minimum, the maximum, and standard deviation of an output. The ETSZ instruction is used for evapotranspiration calculations. The totalize instruction is commonly used with a rain gauge to store the total amount of rainfall for a period of time. For details on all of these instructions, as well as example programs, see the CR Basic help. In part 3 of this series, I will add some measurements to this program and create a complete working program.